see you in halftime or intermission.
Oh my goodness, now they're laughing.
All right, do
pretty girl in South Florida.
I'm scared.
Thank you.
Not bad. Only took 11 hours. Grace?
Yes, sir.
Messages?
President Roosevelt wants you to call him at the White House.
I'll get back to him tomorrow.
Mr. Warbucks.
Good to see you all again. Drake dismissed the staff.
Yes, sir.
And Grace, if you'll get your home.
Helen Trent, who stands out to prove the difference of the woman's first round of one more. Love and rest may not be over.
God, I hope not. Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan.
What's the matter? Well, that's kind of Annie already.
On the contrary. Miss Hannigan, this has to be signed and sent back to the Board of Orphans no later than 10 o'clock tomorrow.
Wait, what am I signing?
Well, Mr. Warwick's is so taken with Annie that he wants to adopt her.
Annie, the daughter of a millionaire?
The daughter of a billionaire.
Gets worse. The little brat. It ain't fair, this little life is yours. four of us? Oh, gee.
It's a silver locket, Annie. I noticed that old broken one you always wear, and I said to myself, I'm gonna get that kid a nice new locket. Here, we'll just take this old one off and—
No! No. I don't want a new one.
What's wrong, Annie?
This locket. My mom and dad left it when they left me at the orphanage. And a note, too. They're coming back for me. I know I'm reluctant to be here with you for Christmas, but the one thing I want in the whole world is to find my parents. To be like other kids. Folks of their own.
It'll be all right, Annie. I'll find your parents for you.
It'll be okay, Annie. Mr. Robux will find your mother and father for you. He has to put everybody in his organization on the job. If he has to pull every political string there is to pull.
Up to and including the White House. Annie, give me your locket.
But, Mr. Robux...
I understand, but it could be our best clue. We'll have the FBI trace it and find out who bought it. You watch, Annie. You may be meeting your mother and father in a couple of days.
Really?
Really.
Oh, boy! I gotta write a letter to the kids about this!
Yes, this is your old softie, Miss Healy's kid. Bird say, until next week. Same time, same station.
Hey, old woman, hey, Dapper Dan. You both got your style, but forever you're never fully dressed without a smile. Your clothes may be dark, crumbly, they stand out a mile, but forever you're never fully dressed without a smile.
Help pull this thing off.
What's in it to me?
Agent Gunderson located the manufacturer of Annie's locket in Utica, New York.
Oh, boy!
Over 90,000 were made and sold.
Oh,
Annie, I'm afraid the FBI doesn't think that there's a chance in a million of tracing your parents through the locket. I'm sorry.
Anyway, I guess I can't get along with that, folks. You didn't turn out so bad.
Grace, do you still have those legal papers I gave you the other day?
Right here.
Annie, I want to adopt you.
Adopt me?
Yes or no?
Well, if I can't have my real parents, there's no one else in the world I'd rather have for a father than you, Mr. Warbucks.
Annie, this isn't just going to be an adoption. It's going to be a celebration, and you can have anyone in the world you want to come to it. Who would you like?
Well, I guess I'd like Miss Farrell here, and Drake, and Miss Pew, and, well, everybody.
Drake, go tell the staff the good news. They're going to be the guests at Annie's adoption party.
Yes, sir.
Oh, and the kids?
It'll be way past their bedtime by now, but tell you what, we can have everyone over for a big Christmas party tomorrow morning.
Miss Hannigan, too?
Why not? Annie, I think I'm the luckiest man in the world.
I'm the luckiest kid.
Well, this is wonderful. Sparrow.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the President of the United States.
Mr. Warbucks, another message from the FBI, sir.
Thank you. Now it all fits together.
Mr. and Mrs. Mudge have arrived, sir.
Good morning.
Merry Christmas, one and all.
Merry Christmas.
Well, we ain't want to bother you on
Christmas and all.
So where did you pick up Annie?
Annie check.
Ah, of course, the check. Here you are, Mr. Mudge. $50,000, certified.
Certified. Paid the order up?
The jig is up.
Yes, the jig is up. Daniel Francis Hannigan, also known as
Brewster Hannigan. Also known as Ralph Mudge. Uh-huh. Also known as Danny the Dip.
Uh-huh. Officer Gill.
Hey, what are you talking about? That's not me. But what about her?
Right here, right here!
Yes, and I believe you'll find that this woman right here is their accomplice.
Me? I haven't seen these people until yesterday.
Come on, Maggie.
Annie, tell how nice I always was to you.
Gee, I'm sorry, Miss Hannigan, but remember the one thing you always taught me. Never tell a lie.
Right. I'm taking this with me.
It's all your fault.
Now you don't want to drag me into this for that. Miss Hannigan's gone for good.
Deal. Hey, I'd rather like that.